Welcome to the next module of AI, which is called as a relate module. This module, we are going to study with the objective in mind, how AI is there in our day-to-day lives and how it is going to affect us in the future. Let us take a few seconds to analyze. Let's look around and observe, think over, reflect on our daily life and routine. The moment we get up in the morning, we check our smartphones to see the weather report, to see the news, to see the notifications in the social networking sites, to check the WhatsApp messages and the other things. Behind all these things is the concept of AI. Sometimes we know, sometimes we do not know. We use our smartphones and we are there in the social networking sites, making us available online. And we use certain gadgets like smart watches and smart TV to see the favorite movie or to listen to the favorite song. In all these things that I've mentioned here, unknowingly or knowingly, artificial intelligence is there. So this chapter is basically called as what? As the relate module for AI in daily life. The obvious things that we are using frequently nowadays is social media, email, chatbots and assistants, online shopping, games, learning platforms, movie, music, and news. So in all these things, whatever I have mentioned over here, everywhere AI is there. That's what I told you. We are using it regularly. Sometimes we know, but sometimes we do not know. Okay. So let us proceed further to dwell more upon these particular concepts. The first one is social media. What is the use of this social media? What is it used for? It is basically used for connecting with our family and friends. But nowadays, it is used for business purposes also. Now, who puts the contents in the social media sites? Obviously, we, the people who are using it. We may use it, as I told you, for connecting with our family and friends, with our business acquaintances, or to do some kind of online shopping. Now, what is the responsibility of these platforms? Now, when such huge amount of data is being loaded in this particular social media sites, now there lies a lot of responsibility. The responsibility of these particular apps is to restrict the use of abusive language, racial comments, violent pictures and videos, because sometimes some videos and pictures will not be age appropriate. So we should be checking those things in order to do that. Cyberbullying, cyber stalking, all these things should be prevented. Now, in a day-to-day basis, if I calculate and tell you that there are billions of posts that are being put on this social networking sites. Now, to handle such amount of data, we cannot do with the normal database management systems or other softwares. So what is that we are going to use? Yes, your guess is right. We are going to use artificial intelligence. So here comes the AI part. The AI's deep learning algorithms on Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, etc. monitor and check these contents very fast and efficiently. Now, let me relate to you this to one more concept. In the previous video lectures, we have learned that AI is capable of handling huge amount of data, which is called as big data. And the processes which are made of the fifth generation are also able to handle these kind of complex algorithms and machine learning concepts. So the AI concept, which is there in these social media or social networking sites, they are going to check the content because a human being cannot sit for hours together and do that. So who is going to do that? The machine learning algorithms are going to do. So in this process, what happens? The AI enhances its learning and increases its own efficiency. In the machine learning algorithms, we learned that there are three types of machine learning concepts. One is supervised, the other one is unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. So depending on the requirement, these social networking media sites or the apps, they use the required ML algorithm and it is going to train itself to be more efficient in the future. Nowadays, you know that we are getting warnings for the content and the type of material that we are putting in the social networking sites. who is doing all this work, who is checking everything? Obviously, the AI algorithm. And if we do such kind of postings in these social networking sites, we are seeing that the accounts of people are getting blocked by the website admin. So now I think the pretext or the context of this particular chapter, you are able to understand. We are trying to relate AI to the day-to-day things that we are doing. I picked up social media first. What is the reason? Because the first thing that we do in the morning, we see our social networking sites, WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook. It may be for a formal purpose or informal purpose, that is business or personal purposes also. So that is why AI is able to come into picture and help in doing all these things. Now, few other systematic definitions or points I have mentioned over here, that how AI can help social media in other way. So the learning part can be done by the AI because it has got the machine learning algorithms. So the learning part is done by the ML to know the user preferences and recommend the friends, groups, and the tweets also. So depending on what I like, the social media is going to recommend or show those things for me. And it is going to learn the user browsing behavior and recommends events, products, and services. That also we have seen in Instagram or Facebook. We get recommendations because of our browsing behavior. Next, delete offensive material and counter cyberbullying. This is the most important thing because it's not that we are anonymous in or we are behind the scenes in social media. We cannot just put whatever we want. We have to be very, very sensible. We have to maintain the netiquettes or the right behavior in the social media also. But you know, human beings tend to violate those kind of, the markings. So then we should have a algorithm to maintain that. So it is going to do that. Enhance the overall user experience to maintain good customer relations. See, that is what, why are we going back to Facebook and Instagram? The reason being that we are getting a kind of thrill. We are getting happy. So it is enhancing the user experience. It is tailoring the feed of timelines and notifications according to users' past interest. So after 3 or 4 years, whichever friend have become, a beautiful video is made by Facebook. What I like and everything, the best photos of mine which have been liked, all those things are coming. And it is going to know the timelines and notifications, and it is going to show that to the user. Making job matches and network prospective candidate with a potential employer on personal networking platforms such as LinkedIn. This is the new era that we have come. People are not going to person to person to say that, okay, I'm so and so, I'm good, I have studied these things and I'm good at these skills. No, it is not the way that is going on. Whatever we are achieving, we are putting in the LinkedIn site. That is also social networking site. Now people are seeing those LinkedIn sites and they're matching for their requirements and then they're calling for people to work for them. They're knowing the required right skill set, whether they have or not. So LinkedIn is one of the best place that is being used by youngsters and everybody now for getting the best job that they want. And the last but the least important thing is identifying objects, different objects in the images and search them online. It's not always necessary to just type and find. Sometimes people do not know how to type. So what we can do, we can show the image and it is going to check the image. Image matching will be done. And then the required search result is going to come to me. So you can see in the background of social media, as the days are progressing, we are seeing that AI is playing a very, very important role or a major role in making our lives much simpler, much better. And the most important thing is enhancing our experience of using these apps. And behind these intelligent apps, what is there and AI is there. So that's it for today's session. In the next session, we are going to learn the next things like email and chat box and other things, how AI is being used in those areas. And I hope you are all enjoying this, learning the interesting concepts of AI that is related to relate modules. Till then, take care.